reminds us of where we started and where we are today under the very vibrant administration of His Excellency Engineer Chief David Mwendubai. The governor has, through the inspiration of God, established a solid foundation, an environment that will be long-lasting, that will create opportunities, vistas of opportunities for investment, for businesses to try. The governor has also established critical facilities, commercial facilities, talking about international market, airport, shopping mall, of course, the various network of roads. Of course, the beautiful city that we have, the metropolis that has been put in place to make Ebonyi State a global village. And what it means is that at this point, we are looking at investors to come, local, national investors to come to Ebonyi State to invest. Well, by way of security, one can say that Ebonyi State has the safest security profile among the states of the Federation. And so we have got all it takes. We have got the good governance, the due process, system that will make for investors to come here and really have a very, profitable adventure in Ebonyi State. And so we would also mention that this opportunity will be given to let the whole world know that we also have got the human capital development, the capacity, to drive the environment. That is the mental capacity, moral capacity, even the psychological capacity. Because as I speak with you, we no longer wear the clothes of inferiority complex. We are now enjoying or savoring the self, a sense of self-esteem and a sense of self-worth. And that's what the governor has to do. Internally, the people of Ebonyi State must demonstrate gratitude and appreciation at all times to the governor, who came at a time we had the most turbulent economy, economic recession was at its peak, and it came in a very turbulent way, becoming the first deputy governor to be made governor at the stiffest opposition of his boss. And today we are enjoying the dividends of democracy. We are enjoying freedom, we are enjoying unity of purpose, we are enjoying love for one another among the three senatorial zones. We are enjoying a sense of self-worth, even beyond the shores of the state. Ebonyians outside the shores of the state, those in diaspora, are really happy. They are now very eager to identify with the cause of Ebonyi State because we have a governor that has made all this possible. And so a forum like this is used to really talk to our big business conglomerates, to tell them that we are set, we are now set for investment, for business of all types in Ebonyi State. I can tell you that with the airport that we have, with the stadium that we are going to have, we will not have issues with a very, creative industry here and there that we are, beginning to lay foundation for. We are going to say that in all this time, the issue of economic development, robust economic development, will be a thing that we are going to actualize. Because the governor's target is that we should be the economic hub of the Southeast. The governor's target is that there should be robust economic development to differentiate between economic development and economic growth. A situation whereby we will have something to put on our table. Even without relying on white-collar jobs, without relying even on civil service and public service, we can have second address. We have got a lot of opportunities in agriculture, a lot of opportunities in human capital development. I've got a lot of opportunities in business development, in market development, for us to develop ourselves, to really speak for ourselves, fend for ourselves, talk to ourselves, and see that we can move as a people of one destiny, one cause, one God. And what it goes to show you that the Ebonyi State is now like the Nazareth of the world. We have an exporting community in the person of our dear governor. By character, by contacts, by track records, by a lot of leadership qualities, real leadership, extraordinary leadership qualities. One can say that if the country was the best, for this our nation, they can come to Ebonyi State and fetch one. We want characters like that of our governor to be at the helm of affairs at the national level, to change the narrative. Just like the narrative of Ebonyi State has been changed. That's the way we want the narrative of Nigeria to be changed. And it is very possible. Me and you, we have to say we can do it.